What's up guys, welcome back to the channel. Apple just released iPadOS 15 days ago, and many users just updated their iPad to the newest system in the first time. However, no matter you're updating to iPadOS 15 or just restoring iPadOS 15, you might meet this screen, showing support.apple.com/iPad/restore and couldn't move on. Even when you try to turn off your iPad, it seemed to get into looping. So in today's video, I'll show you the most comprehensive solutions to fix this issue. Most of them are totally free. Let's dive in. So first you need to know why your iPad would get into this issue. It shows support.apple.com/iPad/restore on screen, which is as known as recovery mode. It happens when people try to restore or update their iPad. If it's stuck on the screen and cannot turn on, it might be related to a software issue when restoring or updating. But you can still try on the first method, to force restart your iPad. Sometimes it may work. To force restart an iPad with home button, you should press the home button and power button until Apple logo appears. Let's get started. Here is the Apple logo. But it seems could not get rid of the issue, it's looping. If you failed, try to one-click to exit with a tool called ReiBoot. Let me show you how it works. Connect your iPad to computers. Then launch ReiBoot. When it recognizes the iPad, click on the second option on the bottom, exit recovery mode, and boom, just with one click, your iPad will get out of this issue and become normal again. This method saves your time with convenience. If you're interested in it, you can download to have a try. I will leave the link in description below. If you have iTunes on your computer, you can also consider to fix it with iTunes. That will work too. But recently seems iTunes gets into trouble, and many people won't be able to launch it or use it to restore or update their device. So you can consider ReiBoot to fix it as well. Also, keep your iPad connected to computer. And in this part, we're gonna choose standard repair. Please note that it won't cause any data loss. So go ahead and click repair now. Then hit download to get the latest firmware of your iPad. Once the download finished, click repair now. ReiBoot will start repairing. The running bar shows the repair process. Once completed, that means your iPad gets to normal again. Well done! If you're stuck on this issue and couldn't get rid of it, you can try deep repair on ReiBoot for a higher success rate. This time, choose deep repair on the right section. And you should be noticed that it will erase all the data on your device. So once you confirmed, click repair now. And ReiBoot will start to deep repair your iPad system. Okay, that's all. Hope you've already solved this issue after following the solutions in this video. And now you can enjoy using iPadOS 15 on your device without any problems. If this video helps, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. I'll be very grateful if you subscribe. Stay tuned for our next video.